feel. Don't remove your eyelids yet. How do you feel? I want you to place your hands on the on above your eyes, above that thing you're wearing. Just send some energy into there. And you're gonna close your eyes, and when you feel it's ready, you're gonna slowly take that off with your eyes closed. Okay? Keep your hands on your eyes. Keep them there. Let's count from 11 down. 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You can open your eyes, keeping your hands there, slowly. And slowly you can release when you're ready. You can take your hands away. When you're ready. Feel a little bright. You can sit up a bit so you don't have eyes in. How do you feel? Do you remember the session? What do you remember?
Everything.
Yeah? So you were there, Kristen. That's good. So you're able to see everything. What do you remember about... Let's go over this a bit. What they were doing to your eyes. What you felt there.
Yeah. Massage.
Massaging of the eyes.
Yeah.
Do you notice any difference? They're going to be working for the next few days. They said a month completely to heal. But do you notice anything? Any difference?
No, it's just acclimating right now.
Acclimating?
Yeah. Maybe later.
Yeah. If you have sunglasses, try to wear them for the next few days. So the next three nights, when you're asleep, they're going to be working. They continue to work for the next 72 hours. Keep up
same
in
thing.
Energies. As you notice, you have three guardian angels with you at all times. Do you remember their names? That's something.
Mo, Sanya.
Kao or something?
Yeah.
So that's just some, you know, you have other sisters around you. You saw her? You were able to see her?
Yeah, not too clear, but
Yeah, they were together. Okay, so keep a pen and paper close to you when you wake up.
Yeah.
You might get symbols and stuff that you may want to write down when you wake up. Your knees. How those feel?
them just when it pressed us.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, the, I don't know if you were feeling that naval discomfort there. They were able to release that as well. And
that's, yeah, weird. Remember? Tar? What is that? Like,
yeah, they always
psychic surgery on me. Right?
Yeah. They always say that it's always like tar, like that negative energy, that stuff that's stuck there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Holding a lot. Yeah, holding a lot here.
Yeah, they said they were scooping it out or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were able to fill it with
a bobcat.
Yeah. What were they able to fill it with, that space, after it was all empty?
Just, it was empty, so you can see like the blood and everything, and mm-hmm. it just feel light.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's great. What else? Life purpose.
Just go with the flow and just don't expect too much all at once. Just like everything is meant to be, like, you know, our actions are meeting and there's no coincidences, and just, but at the same time, and breathe, go with the flow and acknowledge everybody's presence.
Mm-hmm.
And being in the present moment, because sometimes, you know, with our spiritual work, we tend to
somewhere else.
And my husband said, come back sometime
and be here.
Your children too.
Yes, yes. We get carried away sometimes.
Yes,
it's part of the work. You able to remember Christopher's? They said they were
making
something
stuff,
or something to help
them fly.
The air.
Yeah.
Very intrigued with that. Yeah.
I think in China, there's some building, they have some kind of system in their building that, because in Beijing they have smog everywhere.
Yeah, that was there.
So the building takes in that smog and clears it out. So
mm-hmm.
maybe Christopher can make something to cleanse.
There's not much of that here though, but but other places in the world, like India, it's pretty bad too.
Yeah.
I was there in Beijing, it was rough. Mexico City as well.
Yeah.
That was cool. All the contracts were gone.
What?
Yeah. And also with your brother.
Yeah.
You said they're cutting all the cords around.
Yeah.
All the contracts. Yeah, they always talk about those cords. The only one they don't cut is the silver, the gold cord that keeps us
alive.
You know, you're sending as much that you can give, but he also has a knowledge and accepted.
Yeah. Should I let him know?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so your contracts, his contracts were gone. You got the guardian angels. Oh yeah, your mom was your sister in your past life. There was something going on there. You married somebody.
Yeah, I think maybe.
That she was involved. I don't know. It's not clear, but that's something like that. It's always like that about jealousy. Something it's very, doesn't make much sense. But I was very intrigued with that life, your past life that you had as a. Felt like almost like Jesus or something. That's what I was getting.
Like Jesus, and then the other
is
one.
Is that
meditating?
What it looked like to you?
Yeah.
Because I felt it. I felt it right away. That
thorns
you,
in my head.
Yes, especially when you throw me thorns. I was like, oh, shit, yeah. Yeah.
Up in the mountain.
Yes.
And then the other one was, I didn't know, but I look back, like, the other one was Buddha. He was meditating. And then he's, you know, that's how he left his body.
Yeah.
And people were there and meditating.
They were looking.
Yeah.
And, that's what I felt right away as soon as you came into the scene and you described, and I had this feeling that, and as soon as you said like the slippers and what you were wearing, and then the confirmation to me was when the torn of the head, so I was like, okay, yeah, that's why you have this energy healing power, okay? More powerful, as you do it more, you get more power, more energy.
Yeah, it's the more attunement.
Yeah.
So this just came up, so my gift back to you is, I want to attune you guys. And it's not like you don't have to go through the whole master course, right? It's just going in there and receive that place. We don't call it attunements anymore because it's not from the teacher, it's from the energy. So it's placements. So it's going to help, both you guys to just...
probably raise more of the vibration.
Yeah, raise more vibration. That's it. That's my exchange for you.
Thank you.
And that would be like a, it would be, I think, 2 days. But you just come in, it's like a journey, it's like a like an experience.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you have to advise me so I can be relaxed, no?
Yeah, we can do like breath work, cleansing the space. Mm-hmm. And it's like a guided meditation. So I'll walk you through and like, again, you like go through like a beautiful place you love. And then you'll just follow the light and the holy fire comes in.
Oh, it's almost
in.
Like
It's
like the first part.
Yeah. Yeah, so there's different kind of like placements and experiences, but you know, it's all about just tuning it up, and I'm happy to give that to you guys. Yeah.
Thank you. Beautiful session. Beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you were able to help me too. We put a protection on you as well. I don't know if you remember. Swirl of light. That was different. I never heard that one before. Usually they put pyramids and stuff.
Yeah.
Everybody has their different thing.
Yeah.
This thing, I was very intrigued because it came up a few times during the session. When you're a healer, what was it saying? I asked it to spell it.
Namo Dazai.
Namo Dazai.
So if you go to the Buddhist temple, the monks would chant that.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot to like, for celebrations for
be healed or will be healed something
all
be healed.
All shall be healed. That's like a good connection because I don't usually
That you could use that to amplify it.
So.
They said that it would amplify the
the
energy. What else? Your date. Do you remember your date that you were born? They give the date, the time. And it was your grandma.
My mom's mom.
Yeah,
Metani.
Metanyai. Metanyai.
Yeah, I'm big, like my sister big.
Okay. Is she still alive?
No, they both passed.
Oh, we should have asked to see if you
I know.
She had a message. Advancing your Reiki work and stuff. And they said that you needed to go to nature to reconnect, to spread your love. Remember that? That you won't be stationary somewhere. You're always going to be like me, moving everywhere.
I know.
We're meant to go everywhere and spread that. That's how I know.
But you can still do your work, right? Like wherever you go, like how you guys just did that on Facebook. And you just find people.
Yeah. Where are you?
Dark cave.
Is there anyone with you there?
Don't see, don't feel.
Is it very, very dark? Is there anything that you see around you that catches your eye?
The black movements.
All around, is there any spot that shows light? Or different colors?
A few lights on the top.
The top. Would you like to go up to the top?
Sure.
Let's go ahead and do that. When you're there, let me know what you see. What do you see? Is there anything around you? Is there any, do you you see any lights, colors? What do you see?
It's not completely dark and it's not completely
dark. As you tell me, it will come clearer and clearer. If you look down at your feet, what are you wearing?
Moccasins, maybe?
What are you wearing for pants, clothing? What color?
It's like the leather brown color.
I see. Are you wearing anything on the head?
Yeah, feathery things.
Are you carrying anything with you?
Like a shaker, a music shaker?
How many are you carrying? Just one? What does it look like?
On the other hand.
What does it look like?
A shaker.
What color?
It's brown. Everything's brown.
How does the body feel? Does it feel male or female? Does it feel young or old?
Middle age.
Does the body feel healthy?
I think so.
Good. Is there anyone with you around or around you?
I feel there are people, but I can't see them clearly.
Are they your relatives?
I think so.
Yeah. Do you live around there?
Maybe, or it's just like a gathering space.
Would you like to go where you live? To explore?
Sure.
Let's go ahead and go to the place where you live. And when you're there, let me know. When you're in front of it, are you there?
It's like a white dome.
You're outside of it. Is there any colors on it?
Just white and then like wooden doors and frame, window frames.
Do you like to go inside?
Sure.
Let's go ahead and go inside. What do you see?
A small hall with a kitchen. It's like circular.
The kitchen is in the middle?
On the wall. A lot of things are on the wall and the middle is an open space.
So it's like a relative modern home.
It's like a one of those like earth clay type home.
I see. Is there anyone in there?
There's a child, I think.
Is this your child in that lifetime?
Maybe.
What's their name?
Apsara popped up in my head. Mm-hmm. Just my daughter's name right now.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Is there anyone else there?
That child is like pushing a baby cradle.
And there's a baby in there?
Yeah.
What's the baby's name? Mm-hmm. And, is it a baby girl or a baby boy?
It's a girl.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Is there anything else in there that catches your attention?
It feels warm. It's wooden fire.
So it feels cozy?
Yeah.
It feels good?
Yeah. Lots of natural materials and earth materials inside.
Yeah. That's great. What do you do in that life as for a job?
Like a hunter?
Mm-hmm. So you're a hunter.
Timber?
Yeah.
Wood?
A hunter, a gatherer. And I see. What do you usually hunt for?
Small animals.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I see. Now, leave that scene, let's move forward to an important day. A day that you consider to be important when something is happening. We're drifting and floating to an important day. What do you see? What is happening?
Like a big hole?
Big hole Cenote where?
Cenote or something, maybe.
Where is this big hole?
Okay, I feel like we're in a cave or a mountain.
Okay, so you're inside the big hole. Are you a prisoner there, or are you just there?
No, I'm just there.
Mm-hmm. Is there anyone else with you there? There's a few people there?
Mm-hmm.
Are those your family members? Or are they just hunting as well?
Yeah, like, they're not my family.
Mm-hmm. But they're with you there?
Yeah, like, I'm looking at something or whatever.
What are they looking at?
Like something in that hole, a big hole in the ground.
Oh, in the ground? It's like down in the ground?
Yeah, down in the ground.
Uh-huh. Maybe something fell in there? Maybe there's an animal fell in there?
I don't know, we're just waiting for something to come up.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to ask the other members that are there? See what they're waiting for. Sometimes they'll be able to tell you.
It's a dragon.
A dragon?
A dragon.
Huh. I see. What does this place look like? What does the forest, the vegetation look like?
Mm. So it's not a cave, but it's like there's an opening, like a upside down V shape.
Mm-hmm.
It takes you out. Just, but the hole is big, it's very wide, it takes up most of the ground space, so you're just standing on the rim.
I see. And the other people that are there with you, what do they look like? Do they look scared or happy or worried? What are their expressions?
They're
scared?
Anxious.
Anxious. They're waiting for something.
Yeah.
Hmm. I see.
Blue skin.
They have blue skin?
Blue skin they're not fully clothed, but they, you know, kind of like covered in their special areas and rope, like a rope or something like that.
I see. What about if you look down at your feet, what are you wearing? How do your feet look like?
Sandals.
Okay. And for clothing?
Blue. I feel like my feet is blue.
Yeah, that's fine. Let's not analyze it. What are you wearing for clothing? Some sort of armor.
Yeah.
Like Kevlar.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And what about, are you wearing anything in the head?
That's maybe a crown.
I see. But does it feel that's part of your head? Or does it feel that's on your head? It's a material, so it's some sort of a helmet or something. Or a crown, like you said. Are you carrying anything with you?
Yeah, like metal weapon. Like on the left is like a fork.
Mm-hmm.
On the right is like a long dumbbell or something.
I see. I see. And how does the body feel? Does it feel male or female?
It's male.
Does it feel young or old?
Mm-hmm. Like older.
Does
Not
it
like
feel,
an old person.
Does the body feel healthy?
Yeah, strong.
Great. We're gonna go ahead and leave that scene, and we're gonna move forward to when whatever came out of this hole, just before it comes out, we're gonna move to that scene there. Let me know when you're there.
Okay.
So you're there.
Yeah.
And what is coming out of this hole now?
It's a beautiful greenish dragon that was flying upward.
Flying upwards to the sky.
Yeah.
What does the sky look like from there?
It's white. I mean, it's blue.
Mm-hmm.
Clear clouds.
There's clouds as well. Are those people that were with you, are they still around you?
Yes.
How many?
Maybe four.
Mm-hmm. And this dragon, what kind of green is it? It's a fluorescent green?
Too limey green, but
mm-hmm.
And not light green, just in between.
Okay, in between, like a middle green. And what are the beings there doing? Are they just watching it, or?
Just watching it rise up.
Is that, like, part of you guys? Is he the dragon with you guys?
Yeah, maybe he's part of the team.
Okay, let's see. That's what I thought. Hmm. Do you live around there?
No, maybe it was like a journey there.
A journey. How did you get there?
Maybe horses.
Horses. Hmm. So you do live around there.
It was, you know, going through valleys and stuff to get to this place.
Mm-hmm. So it's a bit far.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is there anything else around there that you need to see that catches your attention?
It's, you know, it's high up and there's mountains and sharp peaks, but on the outside it's like this green
mm-hmm.
fertile valley.
How's the energy feel?
It's beautiful, refreshing.
Yes, let's absorb some of that beautiful, refreshing energy. Let's just breathe it in deep and How's that feel?
Nice.
Let's remember that scene. So we can always get that energy that's there. Now, we're gonna go ahead and leave that scene and move forward to the last day of your life in this lifetime we're watching right now. We're drifting and floating to the last day in this lifetime we're watching. What is happening? What do you see? Look around you. What do you see?
There's people and there's fire in the torches, and I guess, I don't know, maybe that's my body. It's wrapped
okay.
Like a mummy and and ropes around it. I think maybe getting ready to burn it.
I see. And how do you feel about that? How did you feel?
Died for a good cause or something.
How did you die?
Maybe like in a war or something?
Let's see. Who was this war against?
Neighboring
people. I see. And the people that are around you, what do they look like? Are they sad or are they content?
Yeah. Everything, I mean, everything was all white. They were wearing white and wrapped in white.
Everybody's wearing white.
Yeah. Sad.
Sad. I see.
I feel like I'm in Rome or something like that. It's like the architecture and the buildings.
What do you think was the purpose of that lifetime?
I think trying to do good and maybe like try to meet everybody's expectations for doing good.
And how do you feel about that?
I think for others, but I think not for myself.
What else would you have wanted to accomplish in that life? Is there something?
Maybe more for myself.
More for yourself. Floating and drifting, you are now at another time and place. What do you see? Look around you.
Like the coast. It feels like the green mountains and you're at the coast.
I see. The green mountains. Do you live around there?
Maybe on the top of the mountain.
I see. If you look down at your feet, what are you wearing?
Shoes made of vines and twigs.
What color are they? see. What are you wearing for clothing?
Thorns?
Mm-hmm. Are you carrying anything?
Water jug.
It's a water jug?
Mm-hmm.
It has water in it?
Mm-hmm.
How many of those are you carrying?
Just one.
Just one. Does your body feel male or female?
Male.
Does the body feel young or old?
Old.
Does the body feel healthy?
Yes.
Great. Is there anyone with you around there?
I'm not sure. I just see myself.
Mm-hmm. How do you see yourself?
Standing and looking down to the coast of the ocean.
The ocean. What does this ocean look like? The water.
It's
what kind of blue is this?
Mm-hmm.
Is it blue or green?
Yeah, it changes colors from the different depths.
Mm-hmm.
It's more like it's blue.
Bluish. How does the weather feel? Feel cold, warm.
It's nice, warm.
Mm-hmm. So you live around there. Let's go to where you live in that lifetime. When you're in front of it, let me know.
The home is part of the hills.
I see. So you just live around there.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Do you live with anybody around there?
My family and my children.
How many children do you have in that lifetime?
I see two.
What are their names?
So?
Mm-hmm. So? What else?
Bob?
Mm-hmm. So and Bob. I see. What about your spouse in that lifetime? What's her name? Zara.
Mm-hmm.
Great. Beautiful. What do you do for a pastime in that lifetime?
It feels like healing work.
Mm-hmm. That's what I thought. How do you heal them? How do you heal the people?
Maybe with that water that I carry.
The water. Do you search for this water somewhere, or you just make it? Where does this water come from? earth. It's earth water. But where does he get it? Where do you get it?
Drips from the walls and puddles.
I see. So it's like a natural source of water. And this is the only thing you do to clear the people? You use some sort of energy as well?
I feel, yeah, you see my hands. Yeah,
using
the movement of the hands.
What does it feel like?
Just working out a lot with the left hand.
Yeah. Does it feel warm energy?
Yes.
That's beautiful. Okay. And so you just heal everybody, animals, people, beings, everything.
Whatever is around.
I see. Is there something that you have to say when you heal them?
Amortaza comes up.
What is it?
Amortaza.
Beautiful. Okay, is there anything around there that catches your attention that you must see, that you must experience?
Yeah, natural beauty of the mountainside. It's all green and goes up like karst and
yeah.
Natural beauty.
How's that feel?
Beautiful.
Let's absorb some of that beauty. Just to keep a mental picture of that. To always have it with you, to always carry it within you. Can we do that?
Yes.
Let's go ahead and do that. We have now moved forward to an important day in this lifetime we're watching. What do you see?
Setting on a boat to sail out from that place.
I see. How big is this boat?
Not big, not small. It's
what is it made out of?
It's wood.
It's wood. If you look down at your feet, what are you wearing?
Just simple sandal.
I see. What about the clothing?
Just shirtless.
Let's see, are you wearing anything on the head? See, are you carrying anything with you?
Just navigating the boat.
I see. Is there anyone with you there in the boat?
I feel it. My family I'm bringing.
I see. And where are you guys are going? Where is it that you're going?
Location, new place.
New place. Is it far, far away?
It's a big ocean.
I see. Would you like to go to this new place?
Okay.
Let's go ahead and let's go to this new place that you're supposed to go. And when you're there, let me know.
It feels cold there.
Mm-hmm.
It's like snow and winter, it's cold and chilly.
Let's see. It's a feeling. feels cold and chilly. Why did you move there in the first place? Why did you have to go there?
Just want to seek adventure in new places.
New places? Hmm. Is it up in, what does it look like, this place? Is it up in the mountains or valley? Something else there that catches your attention that you must see.
It's like a white building. Maybe it's a monastery. Maybe it's a temple.
I see. What does it look like, this building?
It's like a white pagoda with different levels.
So it's like a tall building.
The same structure stack on top of each other, but it's like it gets smaller and smaller as you go up.
I see, so almost like a pyramid type building.
Mm-hmm. Kind of, it's like round, you know, like
okay.
A stupa or something.
Mm-hmm. And is there somebody in there that you're meeting, or are you just going there for curiosity? What are you doing there?
To go learn, to seek out answers.
I see. Answers to what?
Just everything, like why?
Mm-hmm. I see. Okay. Now, let's go ahead and move forward to the last day of your life, in this lifetime we're watching right now. We're drifting and floating, floating and drifting, to the last day of your life, in this lifetime we're watching. We're there. What do you see? Look around you. What do you see? What is happening?
Just sitting and meditating.
You're sitting and meditating?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And how does the body feel? Does it feel young or old? Is there anybody with you? Is your family with you there?
There's people there. They're praying too. They're kneeling and they're praying.
Mm-hmm. Praying to whom? Praying for what?
I think for me.
Mm-hmm. Okay. How does that feel? What do you think was the purpose of that lifetime?
Everything is nothing. It's all together, connected.
Everything is nothing. Everything is all together, connected. Everything is one. One is all. Is that what you mean?
Yes.
What did you learn from this? How does that make you feel?
That we're all the same.
To love and not judge, we're all the same. So we shouldn't be judging. other people. Is that what you mean? Hmm. May speak with my subconscious voice.
Yes.
I have permission to speak to my subconscious.
Yes.
I know the subconscious could have brought forth many different lifetimes for Noi to see today. Why did you choose to bring forward that lifetime for her to see? What was the meaning of that lifetime? Why did you pick that lifetime? The one where she was a healer.
To see the kind of work she does.
Mm-hmm. What must she see from it? What must she learn?
To go with the flow.
Mm-hmm. To go with the flow. Can you elaborate on that?
That everything will be okay.
Mm-hmm. Everything will be okay. For her and her family?
It's timing.
Mm-hmm. She will be okay. Can we go ahead and do a full body scan and noise today?
Yes.
Let's go ahead and do that. Let me know what you find. What did you find?
Heaviness in the back and shoulder.
Heaviness in the back and shoulder. Can we go ahead and relieve that? And help Noi with that? Can we do that for her today?
Yes.
Thank you. She'll be much appreciated. Can I ask you questions in the meantime?
Okay.
Is that a yes?
Yes.
My sister, is she okay? Is she at peace?
Yes.
And does she have a message for Noi today? What's the message? What's the message that she has for her sister today?
Everything will be okay.
But she's at peace, right?
Yes.
Is she happy?
Yes, she's free.
She's free. Is she with her husband, David? Are they together in that lifetime?
Yes.
Where is she now?
She's everywhere.
She's everywhere. She's always with her sister, Noi.
She's everywhere when you need her.
Okay. So her sister, Noi, can call her, call up on her for guidance and help? Can she do this?
Yes.
Excellent. Beautiful. What about Jay's son, Christopher? Will he be okay?
Yes.
What's his life purpose in this lifetime?
Bring peace.
What is his skill? I understand everybody possesses a great skill. What is his? What is Christopher's skill? What kind of things can he make?
Make things with his hands.
I see. I construct things. What are these things for? Are you done with the healing of the back and the tension that was there? Is that all done? Is that all taken care of?
Yes.
Why was it there in the first place? Why was Knife feeling that? Where is all that coming from?
Expectations from all around.
Expectations. Can we help her with that? Can we clear her head from all those expectations? Can we do that? She doesn't need that anymore. We need to help her so she can help other people. Is that correct? Can we do that? Thank you. It should be much appreciated. Are you doing that right now? Let's go ahead and clear her head so she has easier way of thinking, less expectations in life. So life goes easier for her. Can we do that?
Yes.
Thank you. Should be much appreciated. Can I ask you other questions in the meantime?
Yes.
While you work on her, while you work doing that. I understand that Noi, her eyesight, is very poor right now. Why is that? Why does she have problems with that? Where did this come from?
Thinking too much, thinking too hard.
Thinking too much, thinking too long?
Too hard.
Too hard. Thinking too hard. When did this happen? And why did it happen? What was she thinking about too hard?
Thinking too much on every single thing.
I see. Can we help her with that? Can we heal her, those eyes, so she doesn't need glasses anymore? Can we do that? Is that possible? Let's go ahead and work on that right now. Can you heal that right now? Are you doing that right now?
Yes.
Can you tell me what you're doing as you do it? Clearing the energy, releasing what? Releasing the energy?
Yes, filled with light.
Filling them with light? The eyes?
Yes.
What else are you doing?
Massaging the eyeballs.
I see. So, she won't need those glasses anymore, is that correct? How long would this take to completely heal? In our sense of time, how long do you think?
A month.
A month. So what does that mean? Does she have to wear those glasses for a month, or she stops wearing the glasses?
She doesn't have to wear them.
From when? Starting today?
Yes.
Beautiful. Are you gonna keep working on her for the next few nights while she's asleep? Make sure those eyesights are 20/20. Can we do that?
Yes.
Perfect. She'll be much appreciated. While you keep working on her eyes, is the clearing of the head done?
Still working.
Still working on that as well. But that will be done today, correct? It's an easy job. Is that correct?
Yes.
Beautiful. Let me know when you're done with that, with the clearing of the head. Can I ask you questions in the meantime?
Yes.
Noi would like to give thanks to all the contracts that she signed for before coming into this lifetime. But now, she wants to thank those contracts and release them. Can she do that today? Can she release all the binding of all the contracts she's ever signed before coming into this lifetime?
Yes, she can.
Can we go ahead and release all those contracts for her now? This is her wish. Can we do that?
Yes.
Thank you. She'll be much appreciated. Let me know when all the binding of all the contracts she's ever signed in her past lives have been released. Have they been released?
They're gone.
They're gone? Perfect. She'll be much appreciated. She would like to make her own life, her own contracts as she goes in this lifetime. Because she knows now what to do. Is that correct?
Yes.
Beautiful. Her sister, baby. Who was she in Noi's past life? Was she there, her past life? Who was she in her past life?
She was her sister.
She was still her sister. Mm-hmm. Is she meant to help her?
Yeah, guide her.
Why is it so difficult for them to be together, to love each other so much? Can we help them with that?
Yes.
Let's go ahead and send her sister, my sister, baby, some love, some compassion, so it's easier for them to get together, to talk about things, to get in touch with one another. Can we do that? Beautiful. Also, while you do that, Noi, we'd like to know How many guardian angels or spirit guides does she have in this lifetime with her? And what are the names?
Three guardian angels.
What are their names?
Sanja.
Sanja is one. To spell it.
Like M-U-L.
M-U-L. Moon. 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 So Sanja. Mule.
And Yell.
And Yell. I see. Can you say them again? The three of them, please.
Sanja. Mule. Yell.
Beautiful. And they're always with her to help her and guide her.
Yes.
Very nice. How are we doing with the eyesight?
It's clearer, lighter.
Lighter. Will she be able to tell a difference right away when she wakes up?
Possibly.
Mm-hmm. Will she be able to notice a difference? Is there something else that she needs to do to speed this up, to make it better, easier for her?
Heal with the hands.
She can put her hands on her eyes.
Yes.
Beautiful. I also understand that Noi, her knees, especially the left one, keeps popping out. Do we know when this started? Do we know why it happened? Can we do a full body scan to see if we can locate, to see how the knees are?
Yes.
Thank you. You're doing that now?
Yes.
Let me know what you find in the knees.
Red ball.
Can you say that again?
Red ball.
Where's that red ball coming from?
The knee joint.
The knee joint. Can we repair that? Can we heal that today? Can we make it all better?
Yes.
Let's go ahead and do that now. Can we do that?
Yes.
Should be much appreciated. Can you explain to me in details? What are you doing?
Pinning two hands around it.
Pinning what?
Two hands around it.
I see. What else?
Sending energy and it's turning to white.
To white. So a lot of light in there.
Yes.
Is that a quick fix? A fast fix? So she'll be all healed from that?
Yes.
You will to finish that today?
Yes.
Beautiful. Are you doing that process to both knees or just one?
Just one.
Can we do it to both?
Yes.
Beautiful. Let's go ahead. Let me know when those are done as well. What have you completed so far?
The head
is all cleared.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You're still working on the eyes, is that correct?
Yes.
For the next few nights, 2 weeks?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What else have you done?
The back is clear.
Back is clear, beautiful. What else?
The belly area.
Yeah, she mentioned something about that. But around her navel. What do you see there? Chelsea has some discomfort there sometimes. What is there? What's going on there? Can you do a scan there to see what's going on?
Black stuff.
Black stuff? Where's this black stuff coming from?
Past life?
Mm-hmm. She doesn't need that anymore. She's learned from it. Is that correct? Can we get rid of that? Can we release it? What can we do with that inner, that black stuff that's there?
Scoop it out.
Let's go ahead and do that. Let's go ahead and scoop it out. And when that's all cleared, and there's a lot of space created there, we're going to fill that space with light. Can we do that?
Yes.
Beautiful. Just talk to me as you're doing it. Tell me what you're doing.
Scooping out, it's like tar-like.
It's going to be all clear, that.
Yes. It's all clear.
It's almost red. Clear?
Yeah.
Have you put the light in there already? Let me know when you're done with the light, so we can continue with the questions. Is it all done?
Yes.
And you filled it with what?
Light.
There's a lot of light there. She's going to be all fixed there. And then we're going to feel that again. Is that correct?
Yes.
Beautiful. She doesn't know when she was born. Doesn't know exactly the exact date. Can we tell her this? Can we find this out for her? What date, time she was born? What year? Is this possible?
Yes. March 11th.
March 11th. Of what year? 1978. At what time?
Twelve midnight.
I see. Where? Where was she born?
In the house.
House? Who delivered her?
Her grandmother.
Her grandmother?
Yes.
Can you say that again?
Her grandmother.
Okay. What's her grandmother's name?
Metanyai.
Metanyai?
Yes.
Metanyai. I see. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Can you say the date so she was born again, just to make sure? Thursday. What date?
March 11th.
What year?
1978.
Beautiful. Should be much appreciated. How are we doing with Denise?
It's fixed.
They're both fixed?
Yes.
Beautiful. I understand that Noi, she would like to be 135 pounds, or get to be that. Is this possible?
Yes.
Can we help her with this?
Yes.
How can we help her with this? release the stress.
Yes.
What else? Any unnecessary weight. Can we do this?
Yes.
How are you gonna do this?
For her to go out and be with nature and, and release to mother.
Release to mother. How can she accomplish this? What must she do? Is there something in particular?
Connect with her.
Connect.
Ask her to take.
To connect with her, to ask her to take the unnecessary energy that she doesn't need?
Yes.
Okay. I understand she also works a lot with Reiki. She's a Reiki worker, so she helps people. Is that correct?
Yes.
Can we help put a protection on her? Can we put a protection on Noi for her energy level not to drop and so any negative energies or unnecessary energies come into her? Is this possible?
Yes.
Can we do that right now?
Yes.
Go ahead and do that. Are you done putting the protection?
Yes.
Can you explain to me in details what kind of protection you put on Noi today? Whole body. And what is this going to protect her from?
Unnecessary energy.
I see. And this protection will be here for, will be with her at all times?
She will have it.
She will have it. At all times? Every day?
Yes.
Beautiful. She will be much appreciated. Santong, who was she in her past lives, in Noi's past life? Was she there?
Yes.
Who was she?
It's her sister.
She was her sister. They were sisters in a past life.
Yes.
And now she is her mom.
Yes.
Why is there so much problem between them? Why there's not much connection there? Is it because they were sisters in the past life?
Yes.
Why? What was happening there?
Maybe you married somebody that she loved.
I understand, so there was jealousy. Can we help them in this lifetime? Is there something we can do to help them reconnect at the soul level? So there's more love and peace between them. Can we do that?
Yes.
You're doing that right now. Can we send peace and love? Be much appreciated. Let me know when you're done doing that.
Okay.
Beautiful. So it's all done. What did you do?
Some loving light to her.
I see. What about Noi's father, Pa? What happened to him when he had the stroke?
He
Why did you have the stroke in the first place?
It's time for him to change.
Time for him to change? How?
To not be angry and
not be angry. To not be angry and worry so much. I see. Can we help him though? Because I think he learned from that stroke. And he's changed already, is that correct? Can we help him get better? To communicate better?
Yes.
So he can express his love towards his family members and himself. Can we do this? Let's go ahead and do that right now. Let's send them a lot of love and light so he'll be able to communicate better to his family, his loved ones. So he can be at peace with himself. Once he can love himself more, he'll be able to express more love towards his family and his family members. Is that correct?
Yes.
Let me know when you're done doing that. Can you say that again?
Finished.
It's finished. What did you do?
Surround him with white light, hold his face and kiss him.
Mm-hmm. What about his brain? Can we arrange that a little bit so he can communicate better? Easier. Can we do that? Let me know when that's done.
Okay.
Beautiful. Noi's brother, can we help him to forgive, to live a more peaceful life, to love himself, to love more his family, to reconnect with his family? Can we do that today?
Yes.
How can we do that?
Could all the contracts that he made for himself.
I see. So that's what's holding him back. That's why he's like that.
Yes.
Let's go ahead and do that. Let's cut all those binding contracts that he made for himself, that he's learned from, and he thanks for it, but he doesn't need it anymore. He needs a more peaceful life, a more loving life, a more beautiful life, a life filled with love and light. Can we do that for him?
Yes.
Let's go ahead and do that. Let me know when you're done.
Okay.
Is it done?
Yes.
What have you done?
My hand to cut all the cords around his body. Gave him my heart for him to light up.
Beautiful. So you've cut all the cords, binding contracts, and you give him a lot of love and heart. So now he'll be more at peace, more loving, and cherish his love with his family, is that correct?
Yes.
Beautiful. What is Noi's life purpose in this lifetime?
To help the earth heal.
To help the earth heal. How? How must she do this? What is the skill she possesses? What is the skill she has in this lifetime? How can she accomplish this mission?
Bless places she visits, she goes to.
to bless places she visits when she goes to places?
Yes.
I understand she was saying something in one of her past lives that she was a man of a healer. What was it that she was saying? What was it that he was saying in that lifetime? Can you say that again?
Namo
tassa. What is it? It's Buddhist. What does it mean? Can you say it in English or Spanish or French? Will she know of this? Will she be able to use this?
Yes.
Can you spell it?
Namotasa.
Namotasa. Mm-hmm. Namotasa.
Mm-hmm.
Like that?
Mm-hmm.
What does that mean?
All shall be healed.
All shall be healed. Must she use this?
If she likes.
She can use this? If she likes?
Yeah.
What will that do when she says this?
Magnifies.
It will magnify her healing power?
Yes.
Beautiful. What is the skill that Noi possesses in this lifetime? What is her greatest skill?
Connecting with the hearts.
Connecting with the hearts. How?
To see the truth and everything and everyone.
To see the truth in everything and everyone. Mm-hmm. I see. So she's a healer. She heals Gaia, and she heals all beings around.
Yes.
Beautiful. What star family she comes from?
Lyria.
Lyria?
Lyria.
Lyria? Mm-hmm. She comes from that star family?
Lyria.
I see, Lyria. And is anyone from her family in that lifetime, from that star family, with her now, here, in this lifetime?
Her husband.
Her husband? What's her husband's name?
Jeffrey.
He's from Lyria as well?
Yes.
What is his purpose in this lifetime?
Help guide and balance me.
Mm-hmm. How does he do that?
Help ground. Connect back to the real world, the 3D world.
I see. Beautiful. What is Noi's next step in her journey? Where will she be living? Will she stay here? Where will she be going?
Still to be going and learning and seeing and doing.
Mm-hmm. I see. So she's going to be a lot of traveling and learning everywhere around the world?
Yes.
I see. How can she advance in her energy work? What must she do?
Let go of fear.
Can we help her with that? I understand she hangs a lot to fear. Let's go ahead and help her with that. Let's place a pyramid around her at all times. Can we do this?
Yes.
What are you doing?
Pyramid around her.
Beautiful. She will not fear anything. So you would let go of fear?
Yes.
Beautiful. Will it be possible for her, for Noi, to open her senses, her healing senses, so she could feel more and see more? Is this possible? I think she's at the right time. Do you see that? Can we open up those senses for her?
Yes.
How can we do that?
Surround her with high vibration.
Beautiful. Are you doing that right now?
Yes.
Let me know when you're finished.
Okay.
Beautiful. Now, so we're all done with Noi. Is she all healed? She'll feel much better. She's protected. Is that true?
Yes.
Can I ask you also to do a full body scan on myself?
Yes.
Let me know what you find.
Feet?
Hmm. What's going on there with the feet?
Need to flow, let it flow through.
Hmm.
Touch the earth. Walk barefoot.
To walk barefoot. I need to let it flow more, the energy. What will that do to me?
Connect with mother and father, sky.
I see. It would open up more my senses.
Yes.
I see. Can you say that again, please? Can you repeat that?
Yes. Connect you to top and bottom, Divine Father, Divine Mother's energy, and all the energy in between. Activate your light, your heart's light, expanding outward. And outward to the farthest it can go, and activating your light body and your Merkaba.
That's beautiful. Thank you. Do you have any messages for Noi today, or myself, or the world?
Shine wherever you go, wherever you walk, and share that high vibration to others.
Mm-hmm.
And acknowledge people. Look them in the eyes and smile. Because we're all one. We're all each other. We're all the same.
I see. Can you help me with that? Sometimes I find it difficult.
Yes.
How can you help me?
Go do it. Go to your heart. Work from the heart and not the mind, not the brain.
Mm-hmm.
And breathe. Take a breath before you say, before you talk, before you do, before you move.
I see. That's really beautiful wording. I greatly appreciate that. Okay. Is there anything else that we can do for Noi today that we might have missed or something?
Clear, she's free.
Beautiful.